Economic experts say billions of dollars in power is stolen every year.
A local power company just sent out a new warning to keep an eye out for this silent crime as the weather starts to change. NBC2's Brian Anderson joins us live from a North Fort Myers home to show us what to look out for. Brian?
Peter and Kelly, good evening. If this little lock is broken on your meter, it's a big red flag. Here's a look at it when it's broken. This, though, is nothing compared to the lengths some criminals go to stop this meter from running.
'Tis the season for cooler weather and so-called power pirates.
My goodness, it's hard to believe, isn't it?
Believe it or not.
Because you can't see electricity, it is difficult to think about stealing it.
Beware, because the quiet criminals could be living right next door.
I didn't know people could do things like that.
It is a silent crime. You may not notice if your neighbor's stealing electricity, but it is not a victimless crime.
In Lee County, LCEC says in the past couple of years, criminals have cashed in on hundreds of thousands of dollars in power without paying.
You know, desperate times sometimes cause people to become desperate.
Amazing.
How can you tell when they're doing it?
Well, it was probably a crowbar or a screwdriver or something.
Sometimes the glass case ends up shattered. Electric experts say meter readers can pack a potentially deadly punch. They say 240 volts inside here is like sticking your fingers in two power outlets.
That's unbelievable.
I'm not sure how it was yet.
In 2014, LCEC successfully went after electricity thieves for nearly $40,000 in restitution and fines. But on average, the co-op tells us it only manages to recoup 60% of the crime's total price tags. LCEC says expensive legal fees tend to keep these criminals out of court unless they don't learn the first time.
We don't generate power, so we pay a power supplier. So all electricity must be paid in some way.
LCEC's warning is timely because of the weather. The co-op says that crime and the economy are two other contributors. The latest numbers Florida Power and Light provided me show that in 2012, FPL investigated 22,000 cases of electricity theft. We are live tonight in North Fort Myers. Brian Anderson, NBC2.
We looked into it. Power companies often pass along these losses to customers, but LCEC told NBC2 that over the past several years, they've made in-house cuts to prevent it.